Rvssian and Anuel AA collaborated with the late Juice WRLD and Me Ame with a video that pays homage to the Chicago rapper. The music video features a slew of interesting special effects, but the intricate details that pay homage to Juice WRLD are the most striking.
When I initially talked to Rvssian, he really wanted to like show Juice's face in some form. If we want to show Juice's face, we have to do it in a way that's very tasteful, respectful, and puts him in a beautiful, positive light.
So Genius News sat down with Me Ame director Arrad, who gave us an inside look at just how he and his team brought Juice's legacy to life.
Since Juice WRLD's passing in December 2019, his presence continues to be preserved in music.
The video's concept derives from two different interpretations of the song's title.
Me Ame translates to don't love me. So in Anuel's situation, about him detracting himself from a girl and the girl trying to lure him in. And then in Juice WRLD's situation, it's just kind of a sad thing because it's not really just about offering closure to his fans and his loved ones, but more just saying like, hey, even though I'm not here, I'm still looking over you.
To bring Juice back to life, Arrad drew inspiration from the 2015 film Furious 7 and its work on resurrecting the late beloved actor Paul Walker.
It's that same scene at the end with Paul Walker when he was driving off, but in that section of the film, they actually filmed Paul Walker's brother, and then in post-production, they swapped it out with Paul Walker's actual face.
You'll always be with me. Change the game without even knowing. And you'll always be my brother.
But finding a deep fake for the expressive Juice WRLD was a bit of a challenge, so Arrad and his team took extra care to achieve a final product that embodied Juice's spirit.
It was very tough because Juice WRLD has such a unique look and his overall vibe, so we had to really like analyze Juice WRLD just from his past videos and live performances and try to nail it down as well as possible. We went through a lot of back and forth. I don't know exactly how much, but I would say at least 20 to 30 revisions minimum, maybe even more. And it was like small things. It could have been like, I think this eyebrow is over-exaggerated here. I think his pupils feel too dilated. I think the way he's singing right now just doesn't feel like Juice WRLD. It took a lot.
During his verse, Arrad included a conscious callback to Juice's hit, Lucid Dreams.
When he says that about seeing the shadows in the room, we actually show an outline of the Juice WRLD silhouette. And the girl turns around and she kind of slightly sees a shadow on the wall. So I thought that was just like a cool little tribute just to Lucid Dreams.
Don't get too attached, I'm bad news. I'll break your heart, leave it permanent like getting a tattoo. I'll do you worse than your ex-boyfriend dig you. Next thing you know, you'll be seeing shadows in your room. I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point where I love and I hate you, and I cannot change you, so I must replace you.
At the end of the video, Rvssian, Anuel AA, and crew crowd a roof to participate in a lantern vigil that floats into a 999, a symbol of Juice WRLD's logo and legacy.
You know, all those people up on the roof wearing the white gowns, they were all different ethnicities, different sizes, different genders. It was like a mixed melting pot. And that was just kind of like a representation of, you know, Juice's fans. They were really from all over the world. They all had different backgrounds, looked different, but they all could share Juice's universal message.
Shooting that scene wasn't easy, but Juice's spirit was felt on set.
I'm gonna be honest, that was a very windy day. We were up on a rooftop, we were trying to light lanterns. At first it was very hectic. Once we started lighting the lanterns, once we got everybody up there and we just started shooting the scene, I think the energy flipped like completely. Like honestly, it was so peaceful, so beautiful. The vibes just completely changed. That scene moving forward really did set the tone for the rest of the day.
And Juice's estate added their own piece into the video.
They said, hey, in addition to, you know, recreating Juice as an angel, we would love if you could have the angel wear this 999 shirt. As you could see in the video, there are a couple times where you see the 999 shirts and Rvssian at the end when he lights the lantern and releases it, he's also wearing a 999 shirt as well. I think it was just something special for the fans.
Since the video's release, it's received an outpouring of support and appreciation from Juice WRLD fans, and it points to the lasting presence of Juice in hip-hop history.
I think seeing Juice as an angel really triggered an emotional response. And that to me was so meaningful because it really showed that the goal we had with the original message we want to convey successfully transmitted to the fans. Appreciate his music, appreciate how he was there for us and how he's still there looking out for everybody. And I think I'm grateful that people really saw this in a positive light.
I'm Delisa with Genius News, bringing you the meaning and the knowledge behind the music at home.